The number of times I do my intros is ridiculous. Hi guys, what's up? I hope all of you are doing great. Today we're talking about babies, yes. This one is specifically for all the young moms, teens in their 20s. And it comes with so much love because I am an aunt of two beautiful nephews and I learned 1, 2, 3 things in my time with them, and I figured why not share with you guys the 1, 2, 3 tips that I learned from my sister. So what I have done is I have divided the infant age groups into 3. So I have 0 to 6 months, and then from 6 months to 3 years, and 3 years to 5 years. Yeah, so let's start with the first one. 0 to 6 months, what is super important is to put your baby down after you've already fed, cleaned your baby, and everything is just fine, like they're okay, and you've had like enough contact time with them. Please ensure that you're putting your baby down. You don't want to have your baby super familiar with your hand, such that they get too grumpy and fussy when they're put down, which gets you so tired and exhausted as a primary caregiver because you're the mom. So it's super important that you allow your child to have some alone time, you know, on the bed or on a stroller or wherever you want to place them, but ensure that you're not constantly with your baby on your arms, so that you allow yourself to relax and not just have some free time. Yeah, it's super important so that you don't get exhausted and overwhelmed and get post-traumatic stress. Yeah, the stress that you get after getting a child. I'm sorry for being ignorant. The second one is from 6 months to 3 years. What is super important to know here is your child is weaning, and 2, they're moving around a lot. So hygiene is key. So what do I mean? I mean disinfect your house, so the surfaces, the toys that they have, because they're constantly putting stuff in their mouth and you don't want your baby to have panic, especially during this quarantine time. You don't want to have your baby out and about in matatus and it's crazy. Yeah, so ensure that you're disinfecting your house, the surfaces, and where your baby often spends their time. 2 is the utensil that your baby is using. What my sister used to do is have a separate, even now because they're still kids, what she does is she has a huge bucket where everything that belongs to the children that is utensils, they're put there. So they're washed there with hot water, of course, and when they're drying, they're also put there. And then after that, if she wants to use them, she boils hot water and dips whatever that she wants to use. If it's a bottle, a mommy, the too small to bowls and to spoons, she ensures that she has disinfected them by dipping them in hot water. Super important. You have no idea what has been going on with those utensils. So to be extra safe, please ensure that you're dipping those utensils into hot water. Also ensure that you're washing your hands a lot. If you're the one who's handling the baby's food, even the nanny, ensure that she's making your food in a clean and safe environment. You know, this involves a lot of forks and like smashing. This is just smashing. You know, and making your baby see how I lose my line of thought. Ensure that you're doing that in a clean and safe environment. So wash your hands a lot, disinfect, and ensure that your baby's utensils are also super clean. From 3 years to 5 years, these are big babies, big beautiful babies, and most of them are going to school. So what is important is engaging them. Yeah, engage them so that they're not stuck on TV, especially this quarantine time. So go through their workbooks in school, learn what they were doing with their teachers. Is it numbers? Is it patterns? Is it dots? I loved engaging my nephews that way, because you'd find that they get excited and they'll be like, cha didn't say we do that, cha called it a zebra, cha said, you know, and getting them engaged so that they're not constantly binging on PJ Masks and SpongeBob and whatever else is on Disney Junior. Yeah, super, super important. Engage them, read to them, draw, let them play outside. Okay, not now, but because they can't play outside essentially. But engage them in anything else other than TV. Super, super important. And the teacher, one of my nephew's teacher emphasized that if you want to engage your child like that, ensure that you're going through their work at school so that you also don't confuse your children. Do you know, these days, babies don't read at the A, B, C, D, it's abacada, yeah? So it's super important to go through what they're doing in school and then engage them like that so that your baby is not like, what? Masama? Yeah. So that's it, made with so much love, as I mentioned, because I'm an auntie of two. I hope these things make sense to you, and drop me a comment in the section. What am I saying? Let's keep this conversation going. Tell me what you guys do, or one of those things that you just ensure that are done when it comes to your children. Let's talk in our comment section. So yeah, thank you so much for watching. Do like if you like this. Thank God this is coming at the very end, so I don't have to do this video again, because I have like 5 I've already done because I'm having stupid malfunctions. But anyway, thank you so much. Yes, and we'll see each other tomorrow as I put out more content. Thank you so much. Please keep safe. Sanitize your hands, and yeah, bye.